several times, we had two volunteers on the day to start the stop. I use management for newsletters, I don't know what other people know about management, but it's an amazingly effective program. It was the top thing on the newsletter, we need volunteers to help us at the breakdown. I pinned it on the Facebook page, so it was at the top of the Facebook page. We need volunteers to help us break down. It was me and two others all done.
So that's the worst bit then?
That's the worst bit. Three people, me and two others, was okay. But we've got, whatever it is, 700 people, 1700 people on Facebook, 800 on the newsletter, 8 on the committee. All the people interested in the ecology group and everything else. The only people who turn up on the day were two. And I was the only one that was there on the day. So that is the thing that we're doing.
Four free tankers of beer.
clear aims.
Yeah. Well, it's interesting as she goes up, because I was going to say that, is that I met the objective, which was the membership drive, and we increased it quite substantially.
Okay.
So it was about being clear about the objective and knowing whether or not.
And that's something that I really, really would like you to think about. Whenever you put on an event, think about why you're actually doing it. Because that's the only way that you can judge whether it went well or not, whether you achieved what you set out to do, your aim. Yeah? And in Jackie's case, because she had such a very clear aim, the ripple effect through organising the event and the satisfaction, the outcome of the event was so really, really brilliant because she had such a clear, simple aim as well. Anybody else sharing? And then two more, and then I just want to...
illustrator, Cecilia Barker, and to get people, because the event is swimming in more gardens, and to get folks on our community garden project as well, to get people in the parks. The worst bit was the way getting volunteers in the attendance, so I think it was a complete lesson, but we didn't actually have volunteers. I think we were a bit too over-ambitious with the scale of it. We started with a small scale event, made from Cecilia Barker and the gardening, and because we applied the funding, there was that pressure to, we've got to have performance, we've got to have music, we've got to have storytelling, we've got to have this. And
so
actually attracted what we made from
your aim again.
And then we had so much going on, we needed the volunteers, we couldn't get volunteers, but actually we ended up being much smaller, because the attendance was smaller, we actually could cope. But our worry was, if it had been huge attendance, we couldn't have managed. So really, we were capable of, you know, we were a bit too ambitious.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
That's why it often helps as well that you really have within the organisation a bit of a brainstorming exercise and write down the aim of your event, and everybody has it as a post-it there. That's what we're aiming for and nothing else, because it just helps you.
But I think there's also that conflict when there's a few people on the committee and everyone has different ideas of what their aim and gender is. Mm.
Because if you're writing down email addresses, you always get them wrong. What percentage of them?
One of the